What is up, guys? Today we're going to be shooting a video on how do you build a successful restaurant in 2020. This is by far the most requested topic for us to shoot a video on, mainly because of all you dreamers out there. All of you guys want to be able to create something, actually serve people your crazy creations and something that you've been dreaming of for years to come. Hey guys, it's Wilson here. Just want to give a major shout out to these people who have commented in and support us, because at the end of the day, it's much more than just talking behind the camera. I'm actually connecting with you guys. So definitely shows a lot of support, and I definitely feel it. So thank you, major shout out for you guys. If you guys want to get featured, make sure you guys leave a comment section below or just follow along the journey, either Instagram or YouTube. So a lot of you guys have been asking, how do you build a successful restaurant out there, Wilson? And that's the reason why we're shooting this video for you, to give you just a quick sense of what it takes to build a successful restaurant, the step-by-step. And on top of that, I want you guys to be able to build something that has people coming through the doors. And that's the reason why we're gonna dive in to the five core principles that I personally follow in order for us to build an ice cream shop into an international chain, which recently got acquired. Now, without further ado, let's dive right in. The number one core principle to understand in building a successful restaurant is to know your customer. It is super crucial for us to understand the needs and the wants of our customer in order for us to create an item that they would enjoy. We don't create items because of what we like. And this is by far the number one mistake that a lot of restaurateurs make, is to create items that they like and then they enjoy themselves, but rather creating items that are fitting for their paying customers. And that's a little bit of a mindset shift that would set you apart from a struggling restaurateur to a restaurateur that has lined up out the doors. For example, with 720 Sweets, our ice cream shop, we created this whole brand with Michelle in mind. Now, who is Michelle? Michelle is an 18-year-old university student. She loves spending time with her friends. She loves being on Instagram and TikTok, and she loves sharing moments with the fans and family. And that's the reason why everything that we created is specifically for Michelle. From the item that we created, to our social media presence, to the pictures that we take, to the experience that they receive when they come into our shop, everything is tailored to Michelle. And because Michelle feels engaged in this, she feels like, wow, this place is amazing, she in turn was able to get a lot more of her friends to come in and enjoy our products, and thus we were able to get traction right out the gate by identifying everything and tailoring everything to Michelle's needs. So for you, you need to create something specifically to your customer. Go out there and start identifying your own Michelle in order for you to create a successful restaurant. In addition to that, by identifying your core customers, that's how you're gonna be able to build some loyal fans. We don't want to go out there and create items that only people come in once and they never come back. That's not a sustainable business. And that's the reason why you need to understand Michelle in order for her to come back again and again to bring her friends. And that's the power in knowing your customers, identifying who they are and identifying their shopping behaviors as well. And in addition to that, with this whole new change in spending behaviors, we need to cater our offering to them as well. Whether it is by curbside pickup, whether it is online order, we need to start implementing and adapting to the ever-changing landscape in order for us to serve Michelle better. The second core principle to understand in building a successful restaurant is to keep it simple. It is super crucial for us to do that, because the major pitfall that a lot of new restaurateurs make is that they have so many brilliant ideas of what Michelle would want, and thus they create 3, 4, 5 pages of menu items in order to serve Michelle. But unfortunately, as human minds, we can only receive so much. Otherwise, we would suffer from something called a paralysis by analysis. And thus, we can't make a decision. It is too complicated, and we would not buy from you. That's the reason why we need to keep things simple. Have 5 to 10 different items, the core items that you want Michelle to purchase, and just put it out there. And in turn, Michelle can pick her needs from there onwards. With 720 Sweets, We have only 4 flavors for our ice cream creation. The reason why we only have 4 flavors is because we want to make sure Michelle gets to try our different rotation. And every single week, we have different rotation that comes out. And in turn, whenever she comes in, she doesn't have to think for 10, 20 minutes about what to purchase, because if she likes chocolate, there would be a chocolate version up there. If she likes something plain and simple, vanilla would be up there. If she wants something tropical, there would be a fruity option out there. And it just helps her make the decision so much faster, so much simpler, and thus it becomes an effortless experience buying from us. And that's the experience you wanna serve to your customer. In addition to that, we need to make sure that we keep it simple by understanding our costs. We need to keep items out there that are super profitable. Make sure you work out your math. And in this video, we talk about how do you calculate the cost of goods sold for your menu. And thus, if and only when you have enough margins in your menu items, would it work for your pocket. At the end of the day, we want to work so hard to put some profit in our pockets. And that's how you're able to build a successful restaurant. It is by having profits left over after all the crazy expenses from rent, from cost of goods sold, and labor. That's why you need to keep everything super simple. The perfect segue into point number 3, which is to know and love your numbers. This is by far the biggest mistake that restaurateurs make, is to not know their numbers. Just imagine this, you working 5 years in your restaurant and you're looking at tens of thousands of dollars coming in every single month, you're happy, but at the end of the month, you're sad. You're sad because you don't know why your bank is left with only $100, because all these expenses are costing you tens of thousands of dollars. And that's what a lot of restaurateurs face, is because they don't understand their numbers. Without understanding their numbers, they do not know whether they're truly profitable or are they actually losing money. It's a very different story from what you make in as a revenue to how much you put it in your pocket. That's the reason why we need to know our numbers and pay attention to them. In addition to that, it is crucial to know the numbers, so then that way we know areas of improvement. For example, if we have 40% cost of goods sold that we have identified, then we need to understand, why is it costing us 40%? Because typically in the industry, we want to aim at only 25% cost of goods sold. Some areas that might occur that brought up that percentage might be, for example, spoilage. That means we're ordering too much food and they go expired, and in turn we have to throw them away, and that becomes a practice and an oversight that we have in operating our business. And if we don't understand the numbers, if we don't pay attention to it, we would not pay attention to this operational flaw, which we can easily fix. Imagine, just imagine, that 10% of cost of goods sold that we're throwing away every single month, that money could be your profit that you put in your pocket, and that's to provide for you and your family. So that's the reason why understanding your numbers is crucial to your restaurant success. If you guys find any value whatsoever from this video, make sure you smash the like button, because that just shows me this is the type of content you like, and I'll create much more of it for you. Now, let's dive right back in. The 4th key element in creating a successful restaurant is to diversify. It is crucial for us to diversify. As you can see from the last few months, if you put all your eggs in one basket and in only focusing on dine-in as a service only, then the pandemic would completely wipe you out. Then the political unrest in the world would completely wipe you out. When the slow days, there's no income coming in. And that's the reason why you need to diversify into different streams of revenue. Perhaps something like catering, running different events, or even doing a workshop or courses online would help you diversify and bring in different streams of revenue when your dine-in service is being affected. For an example, check out this video right here where I interviewed Kyle and how he has made more than $50,000 just by selling courses on how to make cocktails. And that in turn is an additional income that he's able to add on top of his dine-in service. So for your restaurant, make sure that you guys create different streams of revenue and actually explore where can you provide more value for your customers. The fifth component in building a successful restaurant is the A's formula. I'm sharing this formula with you based on my personal experience on building multiple different businesses. And this is a foundation of what I personally follow that I've seen tons of success. What does the A's formula stand for? It stands for align, connect, and explode. What does alignment mean? Align means to identify your why, identify your mission, and identify your values. So then that way, you take a stand on what you stand for, and in turn, you are able to attract people who believe in the same thing, whether it be customers or your team. It is super crucial for you to identify that. The second piece, connect. What does connect mean? Connect means to connect with your audience. Connect with your regular customers so then that way you start nurturing them into loyal fans. And when you have loyal fans, guess what? These people will buy from you again and again. These are the people who would pay premium. These are the people who would buy from you over the new guys on the block. And that's how you're gonna be able to have tons of loyal fans, by connecting with them. By connecting with your team, you're gonna be able to have some all-star people to help you out. These are the people that can help you run your business like their own without you being there all the time. And then last but not least, explode. How do we actually do advertisements and how do we actually do marketing? It is by stacking, by stacking, by stacking. We don't rely on just one promotion or one stream of marketing. We rely on all these different types of marketing tactics in order for us to actually have exponential results, for us to explode in revenue and explode in traction. A lot of people fail in their business because they focus on marketing tactics before connecting with their customers, before aligning with them. And that's why this ACE formula is super powerful. And this is also the formula that I've used to build our ice cream shop into a 7-shop chain, which recently got acquired. So this stuff works. Make sure you guys jot down notes and follow the ACE formula. So there you go, the 5 key components that sets apart the struggling restaurants versus the ones that actually bring in profit every single month. I understand this video might be a little bit short and a little bit on the surface, and that's the reason why we created this masterclass for you, over an hour long, completely free, where we dive into how do you build a successful restaurant. Make sure you guys sign up in the link below, because that's where I'm going to be presenting it to you. An hour long of action-packed content just for you. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys subscribe along the journey. I'll see you guys in the next video.